Kathleen Lawler Husted, and I'm the Education Manager here at Omaha Performing Arts. On behalf of Omaha Performing Arts, it's my pleasure to welcome you to the Holland Performing Arts Center for our first annual Musical Explorers Concert. Before we begin, I'd like to take a moment to thank some of our Musical Explorers sponsors, Bank of the West, the Richard Brook Foundation, the Dr. C.C. and Mabel L. Chris Memorial Foundation, the presenters, the Nebraska Arts Council, and the Nebraska Cultural Endowment for their support. I'd also like to thank our partners from Carnegie Hall for working with Omaha Performing Arts to bring this fantastic education program to Omaha Public Schools. Over the course of the semester, over 500 students have been working to learn about three different Omaha artists and their different styles of music, including West African music with African Culture Connection, Jewish folk music with Cantor Wendy Shermet, and Mexican music with Marcos Mora. Each of these musicians will share three songs with you today. Today's concert will be interactive, so we invite everyone to sing and dance along in their seats to the songs they know. Just a reminder that today's concert will conclude with a question and answer session, where students will have the chance to ask the musicians questions. And now, please join me in welcoming our Musical Explorers concert host, joining us all the way from Carnegie Hall in New York City, Ms. Shanna Whitney.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Shanna, and I am going to be your host for today's show. But we can't start yet. We need to warm up our bodies and our voices so we can sing and dance along today. So, won't you please stand up, up, up? Yes, we will stand up, up, up. Excellent, following directions. And some of you might already know this warm-up. If you do, great. If not, follow along. I want you to pretend like there's a beautiful apple tree right here at the Holland Center. And you're going to stretch and pick the prettiest apple you can. Grab it. And we're going to use our breath to clean it off like this. You got it. Take a big bite and I want to hear it. And chew it up. Swallow it. Gulp. There's a worm in there. Ew! Throw it. Shake, 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 shake. But I'm still a little hungry, so let's use our other hands. Reach up. Let's grab another apple. Pick it. Clean it off. Use your breath. Take a big bite. Let me hear how good it is by saying, mmm. And let me hear that big gulp. It happened again. Ew! There's a worm! Ooh, yuck, yuck. Ooh, I think we warmed up our bodies by doing all that shaking, though. That was really good. Let's warm up our voices by just doing a couple sirens. So repeat after me. Ooh! Let's go up and down. Ooh. I think you're ready for the show to start. So let's all use our best voices and move along to the Musical Explorer song. And you can stay standing up if you want.
Yes! Every song tells a story. Tells a tale. Every rhythm has a reason. Don't you want to know? Don't you want to know what makes the music go? Come along and see. Make your discovery. I can sing it. I can say it. I can dance it. I can play. I can sing it, I can say it, I can dance it, I can play it. I can go explore the world of music at my door, my city and my neighborhood, singing songs and feeling good. I can know what makes the music grow. I can know what makes the music
wonder, can anybody raise their hand and tell me what kinds of music we're going to hear today?
Yes,
right here. Jewish folk music, that's right. Anyone else? Yes, over here. Mexican, that's it. And there's one other type. Yes, sir. Mexican music, that's right. And African music, great. We're going to hear three very different styles of music today and explore what makes each of those styles unique. And our artists have brought some friends with them to help us answer a very important question, which is, how does music help bring us together? Let's all ask that together. How does music help bring us together? And we're also going to add words to our word wall as we learn about the ways that we come together through music. So are you ready to meet our first artist? She's visiting us from the Temple Israel. Please help me welcome Cantor Wendy Shermet. Hello, Wendy.
Shalom Aleichem.
Wait, what did you say?
I said Shalom Aleichem, which means peace be upon you. And now you say to me, Aleichem Shalom.
Oh, can we? That was perfect. Wow. So Wendy and her friends are going to perform Jewish folk music today. And Wendy, I don't know if you know, but our students here have been studying Jewish folk songs in their classrooms, have been singing and listening and learning. And they know two of those Jewish folk songs, Bulbous and I Had a Little Overcoat. So which one do you want to start with?
Well, actually, I'd like to start with a brand new song called Tel Aviv. It's a song that celebrates the very first Jewish city that was built in 2,000 years. It's in Israel, right on the Mediterranean, and it's about 40 miles from Jerusalem, Tel Aviv.
Awesome. Let's all sit and listen as Wendy sings Tel Aviv.
Tel Aviv, hear your Chakula Israel, if you bought Gabi Ashir, come up away. Tumbling your Tel Aviv, Beres Israel, Tumbling your Dulakot, Levian Agoel, Shabbat.
Thank you, Wendy. What a beautiful introduction to Jewish folk songs. And a folk song is a song that's passed down from generation to generation. And I know, Wendy, we can't wait to sing along to those other Jewish folk songs later on in the show. Are you ready to meet our next group of musicians? Please put your hands together and welcome African Culture Connection.
Thank you.
Absolutely, Shanna. That dance was called Jolie. And Jolie is a very special dance that is organized to showcase different masks. Jolie comes from West Africa, from two countries, the countries of Guinea and Sierra Leone. There are three different ethnic groups that share this Jolie rhythm.
Wow, and do they speak a special language in those countries?
Speak Fon. Fon is one of the 54 tribal languages spoken in Benin, West Africa. In fact, there are over 3,000 languages spoken on the continent of Africa. The dance that we just performed, Jolie, did not have any singing in it. However, many of the dances we perform do. So later on in the concert, we will all get together and sing a song in the Fon language.
Wow, let's give them another round of applause. Are you ready to meet our final group of musicians? I thought so. Let's welcome Marcos Mora and his friends.
Are you ready? Yeah. All right. Here we go. You guys might recognize this song.
Gracias. Thank you.
Let's all say, hola, Marcos.
Hola.
So, we weren't familiar with that song. Can you tell us what it was about?
Well, that is a traditional folk song from Mexico, and it is from the state of Veracruz. Yes.
Oh, so the bamba is going to be one of the songs that were in the style that we're going to here today.
Right, yes.
Awesome. So, Marcos, I know that you play a lot of different styles of music, but today you're going to be playing San Jarocho music.
Correct, yes, we are.
And we hear San Jarocho music at parties with music and dancing called a fandango. Let's all say fandango.
Fandango.
And a fandango, a party with music and dancing, is a way that we can come together through music. And speaking of coming together, I see that you brought some friends with you today. Can you introduce yourselves and tell us a little bit about the instruments you're playing?
Sure, sure. First, let's start with this instrument. This is the big guitar. It's called guitarrón. It's kind of spelled like guitar and then R-O-N, guitarrón.
Can we all say that? Guitarrón.
Guitarrón. And so that's the big bass guitar. And over here, I have Jose Lopez, and he is playing the classical guitar.
And can we hear a little bit of the classical guitar?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
And over to my right is Emmanuel, and he's playing the violin.
All right, would you like
Yeah, let's hear a little bit. Thank you. I know we're really excited to hear more of that party music later in the show.
All right.
So we know that we can come together through music with a fandango and celebration, but music can also bring us together by sharing memories. Isn't that right, Wendy?
Absolutely. I remember my grandmother in the kitchen making potatoes. She cooked potatoes every day of the week. She cooked them on Sonntag, Montag, Dienstag, Mittwoch, Donnerstag, Freitag, and Shabbos.
Wendy, I think we know this song. Let's all sing along with Wendy. Here is Bulbes.
Und Freitag, Bulbes.
singing the days of the week in Yiddish. I'm really impressed. So Jewish folk music, which is also known as klezmer music, was created by musicians who traveled from many different countries and came together to make their own style of music. And klezmer musicians often use the same combination of notes called the Ahavirabba mode. And David, can you share the Ahavirabba mode with us?
Absolutely.
Thanks, David. Oh, I have an idea. So, if klezmer musicians created their music by coming together from many different places, and musicians can play the same combination of notes, I wonder if we can create our own special style of klezmer music with the musicians we have here on the stage. Are you guys up for the challenge?
Yeah.
Okay, Jason, start it off. Going to hear is from African Culture Connection, and it's called Kasa, and it's all about bringing together different rhythms. So let's stand up, and we are going to perform those rhythms.
That's a great idea, Shanna. We love that you're going to stand up and join with us. Since we learned two different rhythms in the book, let's divide the room into half. So if you are sitting from this section on over to the wall, would you please play the steady beat with Miss Sandra? And if you are sitting from this section of the room on over to the wall, would you please play the second rhythm with Miss Latrice? Are you ready?
Following along with those rhythms. Now, for our next song, we are going to create a fandango right here at the Holland Center. But in order to do that, we all need to learn a special dance called zapateado. Can you all say that with me? That's perfect. So I'm going to invite some friends out to help us learn the zapateado. So let's welcome my friends. And And our folklorio dancers are going to teach us the zapateado. Can we just hear it, Adrian? Let me just hear it. Oh, I think we know this one. Let's all stand up. And this is that cafe con pan rhythm. So, Adrian, can you just start doing it, and then we'll do it along with you. Cafe con pan, cafe con pan.
Cafe con pan, 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 cafe con.
I think you all have it. Let's all dance zapateado in iguana.
Café con pan, café con pan, café con pan, café con pan, café con pan.
Another song for us. It's about Joseph and his coat. So let's all stand up, sing, and move along to I Had a Little Overcoat.
I had a little overcoat as old as can be. Myself a jacket in the van. sing. Tra la 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 la. So I thought a little while and made myself a button in the very latest style. Tra la 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 la, tra la 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 la, made a button in the very latest style.
Which is like having a conversation through music.
That's right, Shanna. There are two parts to the song. There's the call, and that's going to be sung by one person, the leader. Today, Miss Starr is going to be our leader singing the call. And the second part of the song is called the response, and that is when everybody sings the rest of the song. So today, we are all going to sing the song.
So let's practice call and response in Asise Nyango.
And don't forget to dance. So everybody stand up and dance with us.
Asise Nyango Kulo, Asise Nyango.
Bring us together. Wendy showed us how we can come together by remembering where we come from in folk songs and klezmer music. African culture connection showed us we can come together by sharing rhythms with call and response and fun.
Así se ando culo, así se ando.
Ah, así se ando.
And we came together in celebration with Marcos with Fandango and Zapateado. And now I want us all to stand up for one last fandango. Let's all sing and clap and move along. This is Julia de San Juan.
Julia de San Juan, Julia de San Juan, y todos gritando Julia de San Juan, Julia de San Juan, Julia de San Juan. Y todos gritando, lluvia de San Juan. Como no ha llovido ya se marchitó, se secó el naranjo, se secó el limón, y tu amor bendito también se secó. San Juan, lluvia de San Juan, y todos gritando lluvia de San Juan. Se secó el naranjo, se secó el limón, y tu amor bendito también se secó.
Lluvia de San Juan,
lluvia de San Juan, y todos gritando lluvia de San Juan, lluvia de San Juan, lluvia de San Juan, y todos gritando lluvia de San Juan.
Everyone, I want everyone to put their hand in the air and give themselves a big pat on the back for everything that they've learned today. Whew. And of course, can we all give our wonderful teachers a big round of applause? And of course, we have to thank all of our wonderful artists on stage. And now I'd like us all to stand up one last time, and let's sing the musical explorer song together.
Every song tells a story, every tune tells a tale.
That's beautiful.
Every rhythm has a reason. Don't you want to know? Don't you want to know what makes the music go? Come along and see, make your discovery. I can sing it, I can say it, I can dance it, I can play it, I can sing it, I can say it, I can dance it, I can play it, I can go explore the world of music at my door, my city and my neighborhood, singing songs and feeling good. I can know what makes the music grow. I can know what makes the music go. Great job, everyone.
So our concert is over, but we do have a little time for some questions. So if you would like to ask one of our artists a question, please line up in either this aisle or this aisle. Okay, Lindsay, do you have a question?
How old were you when you started dancing lessons?
So, Marcos, let's direct that to you. How old were you when you started singing, making music, dancing?
I started when I was very young because our family is actually celebrating 90 years of music here in Omaha, so probably since I was about that high.
So since the same age as our artists out there?
Yeah, same age as all of you.
Very cool.
Thank you. You're pretty.
You're pretty. Oh, you're pretty. Thank you so much. Do you have a question? Okay. Thank you.
Do you work in other cities?
Do you work in other cities?
Do you work in other cities? Does anyone want to take that question?
Yeah.
Hello, my name is Star. I do not work in another city. In fact, I work in Omaha. I work in South Omaha, and I am a physician assistant, and I take care of your mommies when they're pregnant.
How cool. How cool is it that our musicians are all from Omaha? That's so cool. You might even get to see them, you know, out and about. That's the neatest thing ever.
Where did you get your songs at? Like, where did you, like, find them?
Wendy, do you want to answer that? Where did you find your songs?
Well, I went to cantorial school, and I learned a lot of music there. Plus, I look at music and listen to music on my own.
Great. Yes.
Do you have another type of a job?
Oh, so we heard from Star that she's also a physician's assistant. Does anyone else have another sort of job that they'd like to share that they do?
Hello, my name is Deirdre McKinley, and my real job, I'm an assistant principal at Bellevue East High School.
And I'm Sandra, and I teach at Duchenne Academy.
Woo!
Do you practice with an orchestra?
Oh, that's a good question. So that's like a two-part question, right? Do you practice, which I think is a really important question, and then have you ever practiced with an orchestra? But who wants to talk about practicing? I think that's a great question. David, you got it? There you go.
Hi, everybody. My name's David. And yeah, I practice my instrument. I play the clarinet, and I practice anywhere from 2 to 4 hours every day. And I do play with the orchestra sometimes here in Omaha and in Lincoln too. So yes, to answer both of your questions.
Wow, so you just aren't magically good at the clarinet. You have to practice and work really hard, right?
I like to think I'm magically good, but I'm not. I have to practice a lot, yeah.
Thanks, David.
How old were you when you began taking singing lessons?
That's a great question. I was actually 5 when I started taking piano lessons because it was important to get an instrument, get an understanding of how music works first. And then I started taking voice lessons at 16.
Wow. Wow, so you started taking lessons when you were the same age as our audience.
I was your age. I was in kindergarten when I started piano, and I still take voice lessons. I still take them.
Wow, I do too. I still take voice lessons too.
How long have you guys been practicing?
How, like us as a group on the stage? Get this, you guys. We just had our first practice last night all together. So, but that's what happens when you practice, like David said. If we practice our instruments a lot on our own, then we're able to talk to each other in our musical way, and then we can all come together to create a show for you guys. Good question.
How long was it? Wait.
Lindsay, we'll come back, okay?
Yeah. What are the instruments from? Where are the instruments from?
Oh, where are the instruments from? Jason, this might be a good one for you.
So the drums that we're using right here are from West Africa, and they're made of a very dense wood. And then on the top, we have either a goat skin or a cow skin, and then there are ropes that keep the drums tight. So some of these drums are from Benin, West Africa, and some are from other countries like Senegal and Togo, etc.
What inspired you guys to do this?
Wow. What's your name, sir?
I'm Javen.
Javen, that's a really cool question. Does anyone want to take that? What inspired you? Marcos,
I can answer that.
You want to answer that? Oh, great.
Sure.
Starla, then we'll go to Marcos.
Maybe we both can.
Go ahead.
What inspired me was growing up in Benin, West Africa, and looking all around me and hearing music and watching people dance, watching people move throughout their daily lives, and seeing how beautiful my culture is.
How long have you started? Like, how do you start it, like it?
So we know Wendy started when she was 5, right?
Mm-hmm.
Audrey? Started at 52. So you're never, you can start performing and practicing music at any age. That's so great. Cool.
How many songs do you know?
I think for me, like so many that I can't keep them in my head. No, who did you want to ask that to?
Like anybody?
Marcos, how many songs do you know? Like, can you count them?
Well, there's too many, but there's a lot of songs. The more we learn, the better, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Totally.
What does Ahovissi mean?
Good question. What does Ahovissi mean?
Rough translation, that means move your body to the beat.
Did we do that? Did we move our bodies to the beat? Yeah, we totally did.
Do we work at Breska?
Say it one more time.
Do we work at Breska?
Do we work at?
At Nebraska.
Oh, at Nebraska?
In Nebraska.
In Nebraska. I'm working in Nebraska today, but I'm not from Nebraska. I'm from New York. But I'm happy to be here in Nebraska working and meeting all of you today. Do you guys work in Nebraska? Yes, these are all local musicians who live right in your community.
How long have you been playing music? How long have you been playing music?
How long have I been playing music? Since I was 5. Yeah, since I was young. You guys, your age. How many more questions, Valerie?
We have time for one more question.
One more question, everyone.
How long have you been playing drums?
What? How long have you been playing drums?
Audrey.
Well, I have been playing drums since I was little boy. You know, like Christmas here in the United States, back in Africa, we play drum. That's all we do.
So what I heard all of our musicians say is they all, a lot of them, most of them started when they were your age. So keep making music, everyone. I want everyone to give themselves another big round of applause. And I'm so excited to say that we hope to see you all next year back at Musical Explorers. Thank you, everyone. I guess if you wanna...